Welcome. Would everyone please remain standing for the invocation given by Pastor Kevin Farmer of the Claypool United Methodist Church in Davin, West Virginia. Please remain standing afterward for the national anthem to be performed by one of Southern's very talented students, Katie Brooke Hale.
Hello and greetings. If you would, please bow your heads with me. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the events that are about to unfold. Be with all of us in here and let us be patient and do this ceremony we have prepared. We thank you for all that you've blessed us with and the time that we've got to spend in this college with these young people. Lord, to be with them as they enter into their next phase of life, either to further their education or to go into the workforce. We thank you for all that we've been blessed with here in Logan, and we look forward to being able to serve you in whatever capacity we can. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, who were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs burst sting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Thank you so much, Katie. You may be seated. Joanne Jaeger Tomlin, First Lady of the State of West Virginia and President of Southern West Virginia Community and Technical College, will now bring words of welcome on behalf of the college.
Good morning. On behalf of the administration, faculty, staff, and students at Southern West Virginia Community and Technical College, we welcome you to the 2014 commencement. And we also welcome all of you who are watching via the World Wide Web. For those of you who breezed through or struggled through your academic career, today is a bit sweeter, knowing how far you have come. The degree you earn today is both a milestone and a backstop. So if any of you fall as you move forward, having that college degree will mean a softer landing and a quicker recovery. Our sincere congratulations to the class of 2014. Your hard work has now turned to success, and you have completed the first steps of your life's journey. We are all grateful for the families, friends, spouses, parents, and friends who have joined you today and sharing with you and us. Without you, this day could not be possible for many of our graduates. You have played an important role in their success, and we know the graduates join me in thanking you for all the love and support that you have provided. We also thank members of Southern's family, our Board of Governors, administrators, faculty, and staff. These individuals have had an impact on your life and work. They have prepared you for a career or perhaps a transition to another institution. We hope we have prepared you well. For us, community college commencements are not only a celebration, but emotional. Why do we say that? Because in many cases, the community college was your second chance, or maybe your only chance at attaining a higher education degree. Graduates, there is no doubt that you have worked hard. For many of you, it has taken a long time to get here. Many of you had responsibilities beyond your college work. You had to take care of families, hold a job, overcome disabilities, illnesses, and even losses of loved ones. For many of you, you may be the first person in your family to attain a college degree. If there is one message that you should take with you today, I hope it is focused on persistence, and I hope you challenge yourself to continue your growth and self-development, and I hope you stay focused on achieving your goal no matter what the setback. You have demonstrated persistence, courage, and success, and today your degree is something you own with no one being able to take it from you. The future lay of the land in West Virginia and the nation is focused on community colleges. The majority of jobs will require certificate and associate degrees. When you leave here today, many of you will be going directly to work. Many of you will transition to a four-year college or university. Whatever path you take, remember that in this changing world, education never ends. With a college degree, many opportunities will open for you, but please reach beyond your comfort zone. Be the change you want to see, and remember that success is not going to be marked by your achievements, but by the person that you become. Albert Schweitzer said, "Success is not the key to happiness. Happiness is the key to success. If you love what you're doing, you will be successful." What success is for you may not be success in someone else's mind, but you are not here to live someone else's life. Until you are happy, you will not be able to spread happiness to others, nor give what you do not have. We are confident that your education at Southern has prepared you to be successful. Now you need to use those tools to make it happen. Congratulations and best wishes to all of you from all of us at your Southern family.
Thank you, President Tomlin. And now Brandy Francis, Student Government Association President at the Williamson Campus of Southern West Virginia Community and Technical College, will deliver the welcome address on behalf of the graduating class of 2013-2014. Brandy?
Ladies, gentlemen, Board of Governors, administration, faculty, staff, graduates, family and friends. On behalf of the student body of Southern West Virginia Community and Technical College, I would like to welcome you to the 2014 graduation ceremony. My very first class at Southern was Speech Fundamentals. On the first day of class, I walked in and sat in the first seat available. I sat with my head down. I was so shy I couldn't look at anyone, let alone talk to them. As soon as class was over, I left the building by going down a back stairwell and out a side entrance so no one would talk to me. Today, through much training, I stand here giving this speech to all of you with confidence in myself thanks to my education. We made it. Some of you will leave here today with your degree or certificate and go straight into your chosen career. Others will go on and get a bachelor's, master's, or even doctorate degree. Southern was our stepping stone for future plans. What we've learned at Southern will follow us, and we've all accomplished the goals we set out to finish. I would like to thank the Board of Governors and administration for giving us the opportunity to receive a higher education. The faculty for all the knowledge they have bestowed upon us. The staff for listening to our moments of crisis and our moments of pure joy. Our family and friends for being our support and understanding when we needed it. Again, I welcome you to the 2014 graduation ceremony. Good day, and God bless each of the graduates.
Thank you so much, Brandy. Excellent job. We are extremely pleased to have several distinguished guests in the audience this morning. At this time, I would like to recognize Tom Hayward from our Board of Governors, George Costas from our Board of Governors and the Southern Foundation, Mary Nemeth Piles, who's the faculty representative to the Board of Governors, and Daryl Ferris, our student representative to the Board of Governors. Thank you all for attending today. And now bringing greetings from the Board of Governors of Southern West Virginia Community and Technical College is Board Chair Thomas Haywood.
Thank you, Dr. Teachman. Good morning. What a great day. What a great day. And it is my privilege to serve as chair of the Board of Southern and to be with you this morning to celebrate this remarkable accomplishment and this remarkable occasion. Graduating students, parents, grandparents, husbands, wives, brothers, sisters, children, grandchildren, congratulations on your accomplishment today. You know, Brandy had it just right. I thank you for your thanks. We appreciate that. We on the board, our role is to try to provide the tools and the opportunity for success and to serve everyone in this room and for people beyond the walls of this room, perhaps some watching us on the World Wide Web just now. And it's a joy to have that opportunity, and it's a privilege. But the work has been done by each of you, the graduating students here today. And all that we do, whether we're worrying about buildings or worrying about budgets, thinking about programs, working on issues, all of it ultimately culminates in today. It's all about student success, and it is our great joy as members of the Board of Governors to be here today to participate in and witness this occasion. So this is a day of celebration. We celebrate with you. We are very proud of you. I encourage you as you go forward beyond today to continue to exhibit the traits and skills and qualities that have brought you here. You know what they are. The president talked about them. Brandy mentioned them. Confidence. That confidence will take you far, Brandy, each one of you. Hard work, persistence, love and support for and from those around you, and your willingness to try new things and set out on a journey when you did not know where the end would be or whether you would succeed. Never lose that. We are very proud of you. Continue to make us proud. Godspeed.
Thank you, Mr. Hayward. your wonderful words, and also for your service to Southern West Virginia Community Technical College. We appreciate your presence. Now we would like to recognize members of the 2013-2014 graduating class who have distinguished themselves in terms of either their academic achievement or their service to the various honor associations sponsored by the college. And many of them have served in both capacities. First, we would like to recognize all graduates who are members of Phi Theta Kappa. Phi Theta Kappa is the National Honor Society that recognizes and encourages scholarship and service among associate degree students from the two-year community colleges and junior colleges across America. Members of this Honor Society must maintain a minimum of 3.0 GPA to be eligible for that membership. Will all of the members of Phi Theta Kappa please stand and be recognized? Thank you. Next, we recognize the members of Chi Alpha Epsilon, the Honor Society for those students who began their community college experience through our Transitional Studies program. Will all members of Chi Alpha Epsilon please stand and be recognized? Thank you. So much hard work is represented among all of you. Now we recognize members of Lambda Chi Nu, the Honor Society for Associate Degree Nurses. Membership in this Honor Society requires the student to maintain a grade point average of 3.3 or higher on a 4-point scale. The student also must be currently enrolled in the Associate Degree Nursing Program. Will all members of Lambda Chi Nu please stand and be recognized? We'll recognize them anyway. For anyone who is not aware, there was a pinning ceremony for Allied Health and Nursing last night, and some people were able to come to one ceremony and not the other. Now we recognize all members of the class of 2013-2014 who are veterans or active military. Please stand and be recognized. Thank you all so much for your service. Now we recognize all members of the class of 2013-2014 who are graduating with honors. To graduate with honors, the student must meet the academic requirements for an associate degree or certificate while maintaining a cumulative grade point average of 3.4 or higher. All students graduating with honors are designated in your program with an asterisk by their name. They also should be wearing the white honor cords. Will all of those graduating with honors please stand and be recognized for this outstanding achievement? Thank you all. The USA Today publishes the All-USA Academic Team in association with the American Association of Community Colleges and Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society. Today we honor three students from that team who are Southern grads. Lindsay Huffman was named to the 2012 Coca-Cola All-USA Academic Team. Alex Roberts and Rodella Vanover were named to the 2014 team. Lindsay Huffman, Alex Roberts, and Rodella Vanover, please come on stage to receive your certificates. The certificate says, "Let it hereby be known that the name of each of these has been selected to the All West Virginia Academic Team in recognition of scholarly achievements of students enrolled in the Community College System of West Virginia, presented to the Community College System of West Virginia, the Coca-Cola Scholars Foundation, and Phi Theta Kappa Society."
At this time, it's our pleasure to recognize two members of the full-time faculty and two members of our classified staff who have been chosen to receive the 2013-14 Savas Costas Award for Excellence. The Faculty Award for Excellence was established in 1982 as a permanent endowment by Logan businessman Nick Savas and his friends. The award was created for the purpose of recognizing the outstanding contributions of our faculty to Southern West Virginia Community and Technical College and to the communities we serve. The awards recognizing members of our classified staff were initiated in 1996. Previous recipients of the faculty and staff awards can be found in your commencement program. Representing the Savas Costas family and presenting the awards this year is Mr. George Costas. Mr. Costas is a member of the college's Board of Governors, having served as chair, and is also a founding member and the current president of the Southern West Virginia Community College Foundation. For those receiving these awards, we ask that you please come to the stage when your name is announced and remain on stage until your award is presented. You may then return to your seat. We ask that all recipients of these awards return to the auditorium after the graduation ceremony is completed for pictures. Mr. Costas, would you please come and present the awards?
Our first faculty award, in alphabetical order, joined Southern's family in August 2002. Many students and employees have described our first honoree of the Savas Costas Outstanding Faculty Award as an outstanding person, extremely positive, and an awesome teacher with a genuine desire to help students succeed. One student said, "I feel like my personal success in school is because of the things I have previously learned from you. You always stress the important facts in class, and now know just how important they were. Thank you for being the kind of instructor that you are. Because of you, I feel I'm already ahead of the game and well prepared for my chosen program of study." Another said, "She is not in the profession just for a paycheck. She really helps us learn." Believing in the empowerment of education, this honoree describes the best part of her job as helping students discover their aha moment in doing so. She strives to help her students shape their future and find a path to their goals. The honoree is Miss Kimberly Hensley. Kim. Kim is an associate professor in natural sciences. She holds a Bachelor of Science degree in botany and a Master of Science in environmental science from Marshall University. Always ready to assist students and the college, Kim is actively involved in the natural sciences department and willingly serves on governance and other college committees. She has served on the Professional Development Committee, Promotion Committee, Teaching Learning Center Committee, Enrollment Management Committee, and on the Assessment Committee for the past 11 years, taking the lead role as chair for 5 years. Kim is actively involved in the community, serving as a Sunday school teacher, youth leader, and as an instructor for the Boy Scout Merit Badge for Space Exploration. She also tutors and helps science education on the secondary level. Her supervisors state that her diverse subject knowledge, teaching skills, and attitude makes her a tremendous asset to Southern. She always has a positive attitude, which creates a positive learning environment. Kim resides at Canada, Kentucky, with her husband, William. Our second Savas Costas Outstanding Faculty Award is bestowed upon an employee who has been both a student and faculty at Southern West Virginia Community and Technical College, a Bachelor of Science in Nursing from Marshall University, a Master of Science in Nursing from West Virginia University. She has 40 credit hours towards a PhD from the University of Kentucky and is a certified family nurse practitioner. Mrs. Mary Namath Powles is currently an associate professor in the Allied Health and Nursing Department and was recently promoted to the rank of professor, effective fall 2014. Mary has always supported Southern by serving on committees and by active participation in her department work. She has served on the Assessment and Promotion Guidance Committees, the Curriculum Development Committee for the Nursing Program, the Search Committee for the Vice President of Academic Affairs and Student Services, and currently serves as faculty representative on Southern's Board of Governors. She provides services for the community as working for a family nurse practitioner for West Virginia Health Right, an organization which provides health care to the needy. Additionally, she provides free health care to children who are exposed to radiation from Chernobyl incident. Each summer, Mary conducts physical exams for the children to determine the ongoing effects of exposure to radiation. Mary has consistently received superior evaluations that indicates that she is a valued, knowledgeable, and able instructor. She has been described as an instructor who challenges students to achieve their highest potential. The high success rate on nursing licensing exams is proof she accomplishes the challenge. One student wrote, "Mrs. Powles is outstanding. She shows enthusiasm when teaching. She is excited to teach us from her experiences and is so very intelligent." Mary lives in Chapmanville with her husband, Bradley. Congratulations, Mary. Our first Savas Costas Outstanding Staff Award began his career at Southern in 2011. This outstanding employee has dedicated himself to the Southern mission and represents the college's core values in his day-to-day responsibilities, as well as with special projects in which he participates, achieving excellence, integrity, and being committed are his key attributes. Kenny Bowens, a maintenance worker too, frequently goes above and beyond his regular job duties to meet the changing needs of the Williamson campus. No matter the task, he always puts his best foot forward. His supervisor stated that he is one of the hardest workers I've ever seen, and he produces a quality job every time. Kenny is credited with keeping the Williamson campus clean, well manicured, and running smoothly by his co-workers, who say that he is quick to share a smile with everyone he meets. Kenny holds an Associate Applied Science in Mine Management from Southern. He resides at Chatteroy with his wife, Janice, his son, Brandon. He's a public school teacher in Mingo County. Congratulations, Kenny. Our next award goes to someone who has been on Southern's team since 1998. She is being recognized for the support and guidance she has provided to the students and her dedication to her co-workers. Miss Virginia Stepp, bookstore supervisor at the Williamson campus, demonstrates integrity and a strong commitment to the mission and values of Southern. Southern's bookstore recently revised the method in which it does business, and Virginia readily accepted the new challenges with vigor and an eagerness to make the process better. Her nominator says she is constantly working to make sure that our students have the best services and access to the campus. She has been an inexhaustible source of encouragement to Southern's classified staff and has served as a classified staff council chair for several years. Her leadership style and willingness go the extra mile to lead to many positive changes on the council. She effectively represented classified staff's interests, and she is known by her coworkers as a go-to person for a wide variety of questions and concerns. Congratulations.
Congratulations to you all, and thank you, Mr. Costas, for all you do for Southern. We now have the privilege of enjoying another musical selection by Katie Brown, Brooke Hale.
Each day I live, I want to be a day to give the best of me. I'm only one, but not alone. My finest day is yet unknown. I broke my heart for every gain to taste the sweet. I face the pain, I rise and fall, but through it all, this much remains: I want one moment in time when I'm more than I thought I could be, and when all of my dreams are a heartbeat away and the answers are all up to me. Give me one moment in time when I'm racing with destiny. And in that one moment of time, I will feel, I will feel eternity. I've lived to be the very best. I want it all, no time for less. I've laid the plan, now lays the chance here in my hands. Give me one moment in time when I'm more than I thought I could be, and when all of my dreams are a heartbeat away and the answers are all up to me. Give me one moment in time when I'm racing with destiny. And in that one moment of time, I will feel, I will feel eternity. You're a winner for a lifetime if you seize that one moment in time. Make it shine and give me away, and the answers are all up to me. Give me one moment in time when I'm racing with destiny. And in that one moment of time, I will feel eternity.
Thank you so much, Katie. That was very special and beautiful. We are delighted today to have an outstanding public servant and a true advocate for higher education to deliver the commencement address to the 2014 graduating class of Southern West Virginia Community and Technical College. Dr. E. Gordon Gee graduated from the University of Utah with an honors degree in history and earned his JD and EDD degrees from Columbia University. He clerked under Chief Justice David T. Lewis of the U.S. 10th Circuit Court of Appeals before being named a judicial fellow and staff assistant to the U.S. Supreme Court. In this role, he worked for Chief Justice Warren Burger on administrative and legal problems of the court and federal judiciary. Dr. Gee returned to Utah as an associate professor and associate dean in the J. Reuben Clark Law School at Brigham Young University and was granted full professorship in 1978. 1 year later, he was named dean of the West Virginia University Law School, and in 1981 was appointed to that university's presidency. Dr. Gee served as president of the Ohio State University from 1990 to 1997, and again from 2007 to 2013. Prior to his service at Ohio State, he led Vanderbilt University, Brown University, the University of Colorado, and West Virginia University. He returned to WVU to serve as president for a term in January of 2014 and was confirmed as the permanent president in March 2014. Dr. Gee has served in higher education for more than three decades, and in 2009 was named by the magazine as one of the top 10 university presidents in the United States. Active in a number of national professional and service organizations during his tenures, he has served on the boards for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and Museum, Limited Brands, and the National 4-H Council. He has received a number of honorary degrees, awards, fellowships, and recognitions. He is a fellow of the prestigious American Association for the Advancement of Science, the world's largest science organization. In 1994, he received the Distinguished Alumnus Award from the University of Utah, as well as from Teachers College of Columbia University. In 2013, he received the ACE Council of Fellows Fidelity Investments Mentor Award and received the Outstanding Academic Leader of the Year Award on behalf of Historically Black Colleges and Universities. He is the co-author of 11 books, including Law Policy and Higher Education, published in 2012. He is also the author of numerous papers and articles on law and education. It is my pleasure to welcome Dr. E. Gordon Gee.
Well, thank you very much. That was exactly, Madam President, that's exactly the way that I wrote that. I really appreciate that. So it's wonderful to be with all of you today. Great families. Listen, graduates, give your families a round of applause, would you please? And Katie, I dislike you very much. I hate following you. I want you to know that. Beautiful singing. And Brandy, thank you very much for your great words. Congratulations to all the students recognized. Congratulations to the faculty and staff being recognized. Congratulations to the graduates. I am really, truly honored to be here. Now, as you just heard, I've been president of half the universities in this country. So I have shaken more hands than any guy in America and had my name on more degrees. So it's an honor that I could come and be here with you today. But each time I look out onto all of these faces, hopeful and otherwise, I feel as excited as I did at my own college graduation some 46 years ago. Now I want you to know, I can remember that graduation very well. I can remember who I sat next to. I can remember what happened that day. I can remember where I went out to lunch. I can remember the festivities afterwards. But as to what the commencement speaker said, I can't remember a damn thing. So. So I will keep my comments brief. I will tell you a couple of fun stories, though, very quickly. One was the fact that I'm in the hotel this morning, and this woman comes up to me, and she says, aren't you the president of West Virginia University? And I said, yes. And she said, well, you're so small. I don't know what she expected. Well, you know, my idea of a university president is tall, gray-haired, gravelly voice, someone who looks like your president here. But instead, I'm disappointed every morning when I look in the mirror myself. Then I was in the O'Hare Airport just the other day, and I'm rushing through, and this it's been one of those weeks, self-deprecating, but I was rushing through the airport in O'Hare in Chicago, and this woman grabs hold of my sleeve, and she says, I would love to have your autograph. And I thought, well, how neat, you know? And so I wrote down my name, E. Gordon Gee, and she looked at me, and she said, Gordon Gee, she said, who in heck's sake are you? I thought you were Lou Holtz. So... Anyway, it's great to be with all of you. I want you to know that. So my deepest thanks to your campus president, President Tomlin. She's done a remarkable job. 15 years, I think she deserves a round of applause. Would you give her a round of applause? Well, I often say that education is the economic engine for our state in this century, and I truly do believe that. It is important to West Virginia's future as coal mines and steel mills were for 50 years ago. So I appreciate the way that your president and your faculty and all of those who serve and support this institution are working to make sure that West Virginia has an educated citizenry. And most of all, I appreciate the initiatives you have shown in pursuing your own education. Your degree opens up a new universe of opportunities, and the work you put in here has prepared you to shoot for the stars. In your times at Southern, you have endured and persevered through every test. You challenged yourselves in every conceivable way. You navigated through requirements and electives while managing other work and family responsibilities. You discovered talents you never knew you possessed. You gained mentors, found friends, and certainly made memories. You have worked tirelessly with this day in mind. Take some time today to feel proud of what you have accomplished. I know that all the people in this room and who extend in your extended families are proud of you. Your professors are also proud of you and excited to see you succeed. They have helped to open your minds, broaden your horizons, and strengthen your abilities. Now, this is the deal. It is up to you. Whether you are preparing to continue your education or launch your career, I truly believe, and I believe this as much as anything I'll say to you today, that you can go as far as your dreams will take you. I therefore send you forth with a few words of advice, which university presidents are always prone to do. So here goes. Number one, never wear flip-flops to a job interview. Just thought I'd remind you of that, okay? Obey the better angels of your nature. Read more. Sing more, and Katie, you can do that for all of us. Dance more, laugh more, and complain less. Keep in touch with your friends. It is easier than ever these days, but stop Snapchatting and Instagramming long enough to make new friends too. Enjoy the little things. One day, and let me just say that again, enjoy the little things, because one day you'll look back and realize that they were really big things. Being a grown-up does not mean you cannot act like a kid now and then. I do all the time. I go out late at night with the students. So grab a Nerf blaster and play humans versus zombies once in a while. How does that sound? Your life will not always go according to plan. And by the way, that's just fine. As author Wally Lamb said, sometimes when you go looking for what you want, you run right into what you need. Graduation is not a signal to stop learning. Indeed, it is not a signal to stop learning. Continuing to learn will keep your job skills marketable and your mind sharp. So have a to-learn list as well as a to-do list. Remember on this day to say thank you. Remember to smile. Remember that life's best memories will not revolve around the hours you spend at your job. So surround yourself with loved ones and friends. Remember to breathe.
Graduates, when the master of the roll begins to recognize the members of the class for presentation of diplomas, please rise by rows following the direction of the faculty marshals. Once you've received your diploma, please return to your assigned row and be seated. The diplomas and certificates will be presented by President Tomlin, Dr. E. Gordon Gee, and Thomas Hayward. For those who wish to take pictures, you may do so, but please do not block the aisles on either side of the graduate seating area. We ask that you be mindful of others who wish to take pictures as well. To reduce the potential for crowding up front, we do ask that you please wait until your student is in the line to receive his diploma or her diploma before you come to the front. Please keep the aisles on both sides clear. Marshals and Master of the Roll, please take your places and present the members of the class.
Brandy Nicole Francis. Lindsay Nicole Huffman with honors. Alex Russell Roberts with honors. Rodella Sue Vanover with honors. Caitlin Brooke Hale with honors. Nassam Orr. Jennifer Lynn Spence. Alicia D. Doss. Kelly Lorraine Browning with honors. Doris Ann Frazier. Tiffany Renee Blankenship. Amber Lynn Blankenship. Julie Michelle Payton. Paula Lynn Gore with honors. Deborah Ann Tawney. Thomas Elwood Davis II with honors. Kelly Ray Lambert. Stacy Leanne Plumley. Kayla Brooke Booth. Nicholas A. Lively. Jared Scott Adkins. Joshua Ryan Trent. Crystal G. Smith. Jennifer Nicole Music. Teresa A. Kirkendall with honors. Crystal Gail Hill with honors. Jared Scott Walls with honors. Ashley Nicole Adams. Kimberly N. Meeks with honors. Jerry Nell Taylor. Jennifer Ann Ray. Kayla D. Colgrove. Taylor Danielle Bevins. Jessica Faith Ledger with honors. Megan Lee Batchelder. D. Michelle Montz with honors. Heather Renee Hatfield. Brittany Elaine Gillenwater. Christina Nicole Dolan. Lena Jean Berry with honors. Ashley Linnea Starkey with honors. Mary Sue Doss. Michelle Catherine Adkins with honors. Angela Sue Totten. Haley Brianna Wiley with honors. Kayla Renee Basden Pinales. Laura Beth Bumgardner with honors. Teresa Michelle Lambert with honors. Jackie Ellen Hodge. Jolena M. Fowler with honors. Melissa Renee Levo with honors. Jennifer Lynn Salyers. Amanda Lene Hunter. Danielle Marie Halley. Ricky Dawn Ellis. Carrie Grace Montgomery. Amber Dawn Gallagher. Stephanie Ann Miller. Charity Leanne Christophus. Tiffany Letitia Vance. Rita Michelle Skidmore. Eric Dwight Skidmore. Shaw. Jeffrey Michael Shaw. Ashley Nicole Jeffrey. Brianna Nicole Wright. Amanda Marie Vargo. Katie Diane Porter. Davetta K. Kinzer. Ashley Nicole Lusk. Jesse Elizabeth Murray with honors. Catherine Grace Murray with honors. Jacqueline Kelsey Price. Matthew D. Lennox with honors. Billy Charles Connolly II. Melissa Gail Connolly with honors. Melissa Ann Rose. Paula K. Burns with honors. Jeannie K. Burgess with honors. Lori D. Gore with honors. Heidi Brianne Napper with honors. Christy Sprouse. Kimberly Joan Adkins. Tina Krisha Casey. Rebecca Ellen Crank. Amy Brooke Hall. Ashley Caroline Lusk. Jessica Dawn Lester. Emily Jewel Hornsby. Caitlin Lachey Bishop. Miranda Paige Blankenship. Tanya Michelle Klein. Erica Faith Mullins. Ryan Eugene Pigman. Ivan LaVon Lee. Joseph Ray Adkins. Jackson Taylor Elkins. Morgan E. Ray Kahn. Ariel Shai Wallace. Whitley Shea Alderman with honors. Ashley Nicole Ferguson. Donna Ruth Watkins. Joshua Douglas Lazoo with honors. Diane Yvonne Eisner with honors. Daryl Ferris II with honors. Angela Dawn Bell. Amber Nicole Hopkins with honors. Jessica Ann Thomas. Lauren Brooke Ferris with honors. Megan Nicole Patterson with honors. Emily Michelle Williams. Natasha D. Searles. Christopher Blake Brown. Cody Jackson Adkins. Kayla Nicole Maynard. Alexis Lee Dingus. Aaron L. Scheller. Leandra K. Parks. LaCosta Chantel Newsom. Amber LaShawn Evans. Kelly Marie Webb with honors. Lenza Clayton Vance. Ashley Leah Spalding with honors. Andrew Jerry Harness. Megan Dawn Sexton with honors. Tara White with honors. Laura Herndon with honors. Donna K. Smith with honors. Kayson J. Horn. Kyan Lachelle Adair. Talisa Marie Hagerman. Jennifer Paige Stallings. Verna Renee Pennington with honors. Rebecca Faye West with honors. Shelly Marie Miller with honors. Alicia Nicole Pruitt. Alexis Camille Hatfield. Lauren Elizabeth Shoemate. Holly Michelle Cox. Jordan Noel Davis. Morgan Paige McCoy. James Anthony Casey. Adam Thomas Curry. Richard Craig Maynor. Deborah K. Hubbard. Samantha Jean Hall. Crystal Dawn Cole with honors. Crystal Dawn O'Brien. Sherry L. Terry. Morgan Brooks Leffel. Ariel Renee Gerald. Winona J. Hensley. Christy Carey. Roxy Irene Stacy. Candace Hope Thompson. Susan Leah Garrett. Ashley Brooke Curry. Wendy Lynn Collins. Brian A. Clark. Matthew C. Jude. Zachary Dalton Graham. Catherine Hoffman with honors. Charlie Nicole Gibbs. Amanda Lee Ramella. Kara Beth Guess. Wayman Chung. Dennis Blake Hall. Amber D. Parks. Todd Daniel Smith.
Will all the graduates please stand? Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to present to you the 2013-2014 graduating class of Southern West Virginia Community and Technical College. Everyone can be seated. Thank you. We ask that all guests remain at your seats until all platform guests and faculty members have exited the floor. Your cooperation is appreciated. Graduates and family members may stay in the auditorium and take pictures if they would like to after the ceremony. And now please stand for the benediction given by Kevin Farmer.
Greetings, alumni, faculty, parents, family, graduates, students, and distinguished guests. Welcome this day to this graduation ceremony. By God of truth and knowledge, by your wisdom, we are taught the way and the truth. Bless these graduates of Southern West Virginia Community and Technical College as they now finish this course of study. We thank you for the faculty and for those who taught and worked beside them and all who helped them along their way, their primary and high school teachers, their mentors, their family, their loved ones, and all those who helped fund their education. Walk with these graduates as they leave their time of education now and move forward in life. Take away their anxiety and their confusion of purpose and give them insight to a future of productivity and success. Strengthen their many talents and skills. Instill in them a confidence of being able to find employment within their own state, not having to leave the area to make a living wage. If the job does not exist for them to have, give them an entrepreneurial spirit to create one in the area of their expertise and education. Let these graduates be able to use their energies they have gathered up for the good of all people. Let them be the future leaders, teachers, and mentors that this world needs. Just as Christ sent out his disciples two by two, let these graduating know that they'll never be alone, for you are with the ones who believe in you. We pray your blessings of success, and for their safety, health, and well-being on all these gathered here today. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, God bless you. Amen.
you should understand me like I understand you. Now, baby, I know the difference between right and wrong. I ain't gonna do nothing to upset our happy home. Children.